Section 5.1 has to do with writing fractions as decimals. Writing a fraction as a terminating decimal means that when you write it as a decimal, that decimal is going to stop, it's going to finish, it's going to have a final point. And to take a fraction and to make it into a decimal, I always take the denominator and divide it into the numerator. So 4 divided into 3, I'm going to put a decimal, add a 0. I bring the decimal straight up. 4 goes into 30 7 times. 4 times 7 is 28, so I'm going to subtract. And then I'm going to add another 0 and bring it down. So 4 goes into 20 5 times, and that's where it comes out even. So the fraction 3/4 is equal to the decimal 7/5. If I do 3/8, again I'm going to divide 8 into 3, the bottom into the top. I'm going to add a decimal and a 0. I bring the decimal straight up. 8 goes into 30 3 times. 3 times 8 is 24. I'm going to subtract, add another 0. Bring it down. 8 goes into 60 7 times. 7 times 8 is 56. Subtract, add another 0. Bring it down until this comes out even. 8 goes into 40 5 times, and that's where it comes out with no remainder, or comes out to be a whole. So the decimal value of 3/8 is 0.375. Let's do 1/16. I'm going to divide 16 into 1. I'm going to add a decimal and a 0. 16 goes into 10 0 times, so I have to put that 0 up there. So then I'll add another 0. 16 goes into 100. I am betting, let's say, 6 times is what I'm going to guess. So 36. Carry my 3. 6 times 1 is 6, plus 3 more is a 9. So that's going to give me a 4. And I'm going to add a 0 and bring it down. Then I'm going to divide 40 divided by 16. It's going to go 2 times. I'm going to add a 0 and bring it down, and that's going to give me 5. 5 times 16 is 80. And that's going to give me a decimal value of 0.625. I can write a mixed numeral as a decimal. I'm going to take the fraction part, so I've got a 3 point something. The something I'm going to get by dividing the 2 into the 1. Add the decimal. Okay, up. 2 goes into 10 5 times. And I'm going to get a 3.5. So this is the decimal value of the 1/2. Same thing here. I've got 1, and then I've got to find the decimal value. 4 goes into 1, add a decimal and a 0, 2 times, subtract, add a 0, bring it down, and then it goes evenly right there. So this is going to be 1.25. You also have repeating decimals, which are decimals that continue on forever but have a recognizable repeated pattern. So a repeating decimal is a number with a line over it, which shows me that the 3 continues on forever and ever. These are going to be ones that give you repeated decimals, so you go until you recognize the pattern. Notice that's a negative, so I'm going to go 11 into 6. It's going to go 5 times, which is going to be 55. And when I subtract, notice I'm going to get a 5. Okay, goes 4 times. I'm going to get a 6. And now I'm back to where I was before. Okay, so I could keep going, and you would keep having 0.545454. So you're going to put 0.54 with a line over it, because that shows that repeats. This one's going to be a negative as well, so I'm going to go 33 into 4. It's going to go one time, and then that's going to go two times. And notice that then my pattern repeats again. And I will get a 2 there, so I know my pattern is 0.12, and that continues to repeat. 11 goes into 2, decimal, and a 0 goes one time, subtract, add a 0 and bring it down, goes 8 times, and then I'm back to the 2. Oops, that's an 11 here, sorry about that. Okay, and then it's got an 8, so I know my pattern is 0.18 with a line over it. I'm going to compare fractions by putting greater than, less than, equal between them. So I always have to take my decimal and make it in, or my fraction and make it into a decimal by what I've just been doing. So this is going to give me decimal 6. So you compare the tenths place, you recognize this one's bigger. So I'm going to put a less than sign because it's going to point to the smaller. On this one, if I make a decimal value out of the 1/3, you're going to get a repeating decimal. So this right here is equal to decimal 3 with a line over it. Well, 0.33333 is going to be greater than 0.3 because this side would just be 0.30. This side would be 0.33. So they're the same in the tenths. So I move on to the hundredths, and this one is bigger. All right, your homework on this is page 203, 13 through 27 odd, and 33 through 43 odd.